We're going to have James Wheel from 2.8 Hours Later and Understory.
I'm James Wheel. Hello. I'm going to start with a couple of things, which are blah, 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 the right page. Why is it this conference isn't regarding zombies as part of the arts? Who defines what arts are? Yeah, like, the thing is, how would you even define the arts? I wouldn't consider myself an artist if I hadn't started work on this. So if you don't know, I write and direct 2.8 Hours Later. It's the world's largest street game. We've had like 60,000 people play it in the last few years. 40,000 of those in the last 2 years. It's a mix of tag, orienteering, and street theater. And you get chased across the city. If a zombie tags you, they mark you with a UV pen. And when you get back to base, you're scanned by a team, and if you've been caught, you're turned into a zombie yourself by professional makeup artists. And then everyone gets drunk at our zombie disco, which kind of looks like a really cool underground rave, but sounds like a 1980s best of. And that's kind of it. The thing is, I'm not a massive fan of the zombie genre per se, but it's such an accessible genre, such an accessible thing to be a part of, that it's actually enabled me to become an artist, which is kind of bizarre. So yeah, this sort of shows you what's going on. That's kind of it. So we've had about 1,200 people volunteer as zombies. So our zombies are actually volunteers. They come on board. They trade one day of chasing people through the city for one day of actually playing it. And that's amazing for an arts project to bring in 1,200 volunteers and somewhere in the region of 20,000 paying customers per year. Is pretty exciting for an emergent form. And this all hinges on our community. So the actual zombies themselves, this is such a naff video, I do apologize, I made it like 2 years ago. But this is zombie school, this is where we actually train our performers. And they learn to become a zombie, which is great. Look at him go. He was a good un. The thing that's really surprising about our volunteers is it kind of started off as just a practical thing for us to be able to run the event. But those people put up other volunteers and they gave each other advice and community and relationships and friendship formed. And we ended up with this like circus troupe that followed us around, which is amazing. But it's also been a really beautiful privilege to be able to work with these people and see them grow. So the guy who trains our zombies, Alex, originally started off at zombie school and has come up through doing that and is now doing films. He trains all and runs all of our zombie schools. But is actually breaking away as an artist in his own right, is doing all sorts of monster choreography. And it's interesting that there's been that trajectory for him there. What's also interesting about our event is that actually our trailer, as shiny as it is, has only got 260,000 views or whatever, and you'd expect for like a drone-filmed zombie game thing that it would, you know, potentially go viral. But the media that's generated by players, they come with GoPros strapped here, or sometimes in the crotch for some reason, Lord knows why, is actually the principal way that our brand is represented. It's user-generated, which is a really exciting thing. And in terms of what zombies can teach the arts, like having a multitude of ways that your patrons can engage with your product and actually create your advertising for you is well, for us it was complete serendipity, but for you, if it's designed, that would be cool. And it's very friendly for social networks as well. It's allowed us to reach far further than we would do traditionally. As a ticketed event, you usually find out about such things through posters, maybe a few bits like an event on social media. People are posting about it. They themselves are taking photos as zombies, taking part in the event, doing selfies, which is a horrible term. And that's actually allowed for them to allowed for us to actually reach a far bigger audience than we would typically. So what I wanted to really focus on is the fact that the zombie genre, as far as I'm concerned, is one of the most accessible art forms available. We have people from literally all walks of life. We've had three generations of one family come and chase as zombies. We offer an opportunity for people to perform where they traditionally wouldn't. There's a strange dynamic of our audience being predominantly middle class and the people who come and volunteer not being able to afford the ticket price. And it's this kind of strange thing of like the rich being chased through the streets. But it's kind of great because that camaraderie and that friendship, more than anything else, that people find volunteering is really what kind of, for me, is what the genre is all about. Everyone gets infected, everyone is part of the horde, everyone dies, but has fun at the same time, which is cool. And it's interesting as well with the, is that my 5 minutes done? Is it? I'm gonna have to speed through this really, really quickly then, if that's all right. The game's very, not the game, the genre's very multimedia friendly. In terms of the arts world, like, there's very few things I can think of that you can have a video game like The Last of Us, which is multi-award winning video game that then spans an award winning comic book that then becomes a film. Or The Walking Dead, which is an award-winning comic book that becomes an award-winning TV series that becomes an award-winning set of video games. Or Resident Evil, which was all right, basically. Like, the films are pretty terrible. So it's got a lot of flexibility in it. And it's also a genre about social commentary, which is the reason why it's constantly relevant. Even within our own game, like, 2 years ago we did a game called Asylum, which made players asylum seekers in their own city. That's tackling quite a big thing, and for a zombie game that you pay and you show up at, that was quite surprising for our audience. This year they were actually in search of bottles of water. They were actually, like, risking their lives to get water, which was a nice analogy for what's going on. And next year it's all about extinction, which is the bleak outlook the human race currently has. But it's a fun way of engaging with these huge problems and these really terrifying things. And actually, as a result, that's kind of why there's such a the genre, I feel, is future-proofed. And that's something maybe the arts could look at as well. It's like relevancy, perhaps. Anyway, I'll stop there. Cheers.
Thank you, James. The next person we have is Julian.